He had to come back to the text, man. He had to let her know, bruh, don't do that to me. I see you try to jump out there and start some shit. You know my wife will stab me. Don't play with me. You know she black. Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome back. I'm Van, and we are all the LFR family. And if you're not already with the LFR family, I'm going to need for you to hit that subscribe button right there, Jack. Hit that thing! If you don't see it, man, it's right there. It look like this right here, except for it's oblong, it's rectangular, and it's red with white letters that say, subscribe, man. All right, we about to check out some Bill Burr again. Y'all know we love Bill Burr on this channel, man. And shout out to my Patreon members. Y'all are dope AF, man. We about to check out something called Awkward Bill Burr versus Sarah Silverman Interview. Sarah Silverman, she's hilarious. Bill Burr, he's freaking ridiculously hilarious. I'm talking about, man, top 20. So, and comedians. So we about to check this joint out. Y'all let me know what y'all, I think, man.
It's good, right? Yeah. I'm not related to my next guest, but we fight like siblings. Please welcome brilliant comedian who I love to pieces, but who makes me fucking crazy, Bill Burr.
What an intro. That was a dope intro.
Thanks. I thought we got along great.
No, we love each other. But you have to, we always fight. We fight
it's
often.
Because I go on stage and then you try to correct my jokes.
I don't try to correct
your
jokes.
Yeah, you do. You're like, but what if you said if the woman did this because of this?
That was one time, but, and I admit I was being aggressive.
Micro.
It was a microaggression.
Microaggressive, yeah.
That's called being a woman. No offense. No, I don't mean to offend nobody. I don't mean any harm whatsoever.
Sometimes I read interviews with you, and you talk about everything you hate, and if you added it all up, you would get me. But somehow we love each other. Am I correct in saying that? I think that you love me. Because every time we fight, as I'm driving home, I get a text from you that says, you know I love you, right? And I go, yeah, I love you too.
That isn't me.
Uh-oh.
I've never said, you know, I...
Are you, you fucking know, serious?
Well, my memory isn't good, but I don't remember doing that.
I'll show you.
You say them?
I can't believe you're... No, texts just exist.
Now I see why this says awkward, man. Now I see why this says awkward. Because even I feel a little awkward, like, whoa, chill, B. Sarah? Sheesh. You my sister. Come on down, bruh. I said, I love you. We probably was beefing, and I said, come on, you know I love you. I was just playing it. But you just now saying it like, I'm trying to get the draws or something. I ain't trying to get the draws, Sarah.
Yeah, I press save on my text. What kind of phone do you have?
No, I like delete them after a while. What are you saving it for?
You delete texts?
Yeah.
Oh, I never do because all our friends die, and then it's all you have left.
Okay, I thought Bill Burr was going to be the funny one here, but Sarah is setting it up, man. She's very good timing, very good timing, very good comedic timing.
How many have you had?
Die?
I'm up, I counted.
I have a huge list.
I'm 30.
Yeah.
Get something funny out of that.
That's what you do. I'm not good at that. I'm not good in the mom.
All right, I do like you, and I always feel like you're frustrated with me.
I fucking love you.
Look at my posture right now. I'm as far over into this chair as I could possibly be. I just feel like
I
kind of came here to hang out and have a good time.
He is, like, in the most furthest corner of that chair. He's way over there, and it seems like she's getting closer and closer and closer.
And you just, like... Like, that intro was just like, yeah.
You'd like that.
I fucking hate this guy. He's a douchebag, but he came down here. I mean, that's how I heard it.
I think that's how you hear a lot of things. You ever hear this? If it's hysterical, it's historical. So I think, like, things trigger you and make you fucking crazy. And it maybe means something like it comes from something from your childhood or something, like the ticking time bomb that your dad was, or things like that that were out of your control. And you don't like feeling out of control or people telling you what to do. That's my theory.
This feels like an emotional intervention.
All right.
No, I'm trying to be, my big thing, the only thing I'm really working on in my life is I'm trying not to snap as much. Like, it's like, I just have a fucking temper, man, and I don't know how to, like, it's just my natural. I'm driving over here, I snap like 5 times. This guy had the audacity to slow down and make a right onto the street he wanted to go onto. And all of a sudden, I just found myself just going like, oh, what the fuck, really? Really?
I do that too. Because the traffic is flowing, man, and it's like, and plus if you got somewhere to be, and somebody just slowed down to do what they're supposed to do, and you're like, come on, bro. Like, really? Now? Like, you want to be the one? How come it couldn't have been the car behind me? How come you couldn't be riding behind me and do that? That way I wouldn't have to slow down. And sometimes it has to do with our brakes, too. Men, something we don't like to do, we don't like to ride on our brakes too much, because we are the ones that take the goddamn cars to the, to be serviced, and we know brakes are expensive. And the more we're stopping and slowing and slowing and stopping over and over and over again, we know that that time is coming that we're gonna need brakes. And when this asshole slows down to turn down the street where they wanna go, it becomes a problem for us. Because now we gotta think about our brakes again.
Fucking asshole, just go! Like, why do you turn so slow? And then I talk myself out of it. It's like, he probably lives on that street, Bill.
Yeah.
His kids could be playing out in the yard. So I've gotten to the point where I still snap, but I sort of talk to myself afterwards. So I don't know if that's better or if I'm slowly going insane.
Well, the one thing I would say that is a trait, well, I don't like to be told what to do.
No.
My instinct is always fuck you, a little bit.
Yeah, my instinct is fuck this.
But like, I
walk out. Like, I went to, this is so embarrassing. I went to some fucking airport, and I can't even remember what I ordered. It was some avocado toast with like salmon on it or some shit, right? So I order it, and I'm standing there for like 15 fucking minutes, and I'm watching these, like, one person's making it, and then they just like gave up, and then somebody else came over, and it's like forever, and I'm just standing there. And she got mad at me, and so she starts saying all this. We have to put it through the toaster, like, 2 times. We have to get the avocado out. She started, like, breaking the thing down. And I was standing there. I got so mad. I'd already paid for it. And a banana. And I just...
Why they laugh at the and a banana part? And she laughing, too, because he's just telling the story. All right, let's go.
I got so mad. I'd already paid for it. And a banana. And... I just said, fuck this. I just walked away, still hungry, and then I ate the banana, and it was overripe, and it was all mushy, and I threw it out. It was like $17 down the tubes. And I just remember, I'd rather be fucking hungry than have one more fucking interaction with somebody that described to me how to make salmon avocado toast and act like they were pouring the foundation of a fucking house. And it's just like, I fucking hate people. I fucking hate people that hate their job, and especially a shit job. And it's like, this is why you're fucking here. I had this job. I fucking crushed it.
He said, I had this job, and I effing crushed it when I had it. But you here complaining, telling me how to make some goddamn food over and over and over again. That's taking for damn ever, man.
You're fucking here. I had this job. I fucking crushed it. I crushed it. I was a dishwasher. I was a cook. I did all of this shit. I fucking crushed it. I'm not saying this is the only skill this person fucking has, but it's just like, if you're not gonna try at this because you think you deserve a better fucking job, when you get that, you're gonna be an arrogant ass and you're not gonna be fun to work for. I thought all of that over fucking avocado toast.
I think that we're...
That's a lot. That's a lot. See? And that's why Bill Burr is Bill Burr.
I think that we're not so different, but I could be wrong. You feel that I feel I've got you figured out, and you're right.
I just think you like me.
I do like
you. You like me, but we can be different, still like each other.
Yeah. I mean, like, I like to... I don't like being told what to do, but I do like changing with the times or something. I don't really resist that. I feel like you resist that a little more, but ultimately you do change with the times.
Okay.
Is it okay?
You thought I was wrapping it up. I fucking ripped another.
No, I feel like with you, there's this person you want me to be. So you keep telling me that I'm this fucking guy that I'm not.
Who's the guy you think I think you are?
I don't know. I don't know who sent you those texts.
He had to come back to the text, man. He had to let her know, bruh, don't do that to me. You try to jump out there and start some shit. You know my wife will stab me. Don't play with me. You know she black. Come on now, relax. I'm just letting you know again. I'm letting you do it over again. This is part two. Now fix your bullshit, sugar honey iced tea. Go and fix it, Sarah.
I don't know who sent you those texts.
Host them. No, I won't.
Okay.
I remember driving home and you being like, you know I love you. And I was like, I love you too. Does not ring a bell at all.
When the way you just did it, it did. This was one of my favorite interviews. I had a great time.
That can't be true.
Oh, I liked how weird it got.
Okay. Well, all right. How about this for weird? Thank you, Bill Burr, for coming on.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you to Bill Burr, Anthony Tamanik, and Will Ferrell. Look, America, I know I always say I love you at the end, but to be honest, in the beginning, it was like a joke. It was a bet I had with my buddies, and then I really fell in love with you. Good night.
Sarah Silverman, Bill Burr, man, that was pretty damn cool. That was pretty cool. She's a weirdo, man. I thought she was tall, but then I realized she had on some pretty big heels. Because when she stood up there to hug Bill Burr, it looked like she was kind of tall, but I saw that she had on some heels. I remember that part. Yeah. All right, guys. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments below. And if you have yet to hit that subscribe button or join the Patreon, make sure you do so on your way out the door. Once again, guys, I'm Van. We are all the LFR family. I look forward to seeing y'all on the next one, all right? Peace out.